Hello everyone. From this video, I am starting a new series of lectures. In this series, I am covering the complete syllabus of Computer Fundamentals and Programming in C, or in many universities, this subject is also known as Programming for Problem Solving. So this is the first video of this series, and in this video we are covering the topics of first unit, which are stored program architecture, definition and characteristics of computer, and some other topics are also covered in this video. So without any further delay, let's jump into the video. So talking about the agenda, the agenda of this lecture is we will talk about definition of computer. Then we will see how computer can work as a data processor. What are the characteristics of a computer? Then stored program architecture and hardware architecture of computer. Then difference between these two architectures and an additional topic of digital and analog computer. Okay. So what is a computer? So we can say that the word computer, it came from the word compute. And what is the meaning of compute? To calculate. So computer calculates. So what is a computer? A computer is an electronic machine or device that accepts data from the user, process that data by performing calculations and operations on it, and generate the desired output result. Okay. So what is a computer? It is an electronic machine which takes the input, process it, and generate the output. So we can say it works on the IPO concept. IPO means what? Input, process, and output. Okay. Computer can perform both simple and complex operations with speed and accuracy. Okay. So it can perform a simple operation of adding two numbers and complex operation like video editing or graphics designing, or we can say analyzing a large amount of data with speed and accuracy. Okay. Now, how computer works as a data processor? Okay. So what is data processing? The activity of processing the data is called data processing. So when we are processing the data, means what we are doing? We are doing the data processing. Okay. So a computer is also known as a data processor because it can store, process, and retrieve the data whenever desired or whenever required. So in the diagram, you can see the steps of data processing. So what is the steps involved in the data processing? Capturing the data, then manipulating the data, and then providing the output. Okay. So the data which is inputted in this is what? Data is what? Row, facts, and figures. Okay. Like 10 numbers. Any random 10 numbers we inputted, that is what? Data. Okay. And what is the outcome? The outcome is information, means when the data is processed, what we get? We get the information. So what we can say that we inputted 10 numbers as data, and what we found? We found the largest number. By processing those 10 numbers, so what is the information? The largest number is obtained as the information. So data is raw facts and figures, that is used as input, and information is the processed data obtained as the output of data processing. Now we will talk about characteristics of a computer. Okay, so the first is speed. Computer can perform data processing task very fast. So what is the speed of processing? It can process millions of instructions per second. This is so fast. So the task which if we do manually takes days or months to perform, computer can perform those tasks in seconds. Okay. Then second one is accuracy. Computer works with a high degree of accuracy. And what is the degree of accuracy of a computer? It depends on the design of the computer. If we are providing the wrong input, or if we have provided the wrong instructions, then it is obvious that the output will also be wrong. So it depends on how we have designed the program and what data we are providing to the computer. Okay. Then third one is automatic. Given a task, computer can work on it automatically without human interventions. Okay. So simply give the task to the computer and computer can execute the task automatically. We don't have to check whether it has performed the task or not. Okay. Then next is versatility. Okay. Computer is very versatile in nature because it can perform different types of tasks with same ease, speed and accuracy. Okay. Computer can perform almost every kind of task given to it. For example, at one moment I am playing the songs on the computer, and on the next moment I am watching the movie, and after that I am playing the video game, and after that I am doing some graphics designing. So all these tasks are of different nature and computer can perform all these tasks with same ease, speed and accuracy. Okay. The next one is diligence. Computer is free from monotony, tiredness and lack of concentration. Means what? If you run the computer for very long time, it does not get tired. Okay. Thakta nahi hai ye. It can perform long and complex calculations with the same speed and accuracy from the start till the end. Okay. Then the power of remembering. Okay. Large amount of data and information can be stored in the computer and retrieved whenever required because of its secondary storage capability. Okay. As we know that in the secondary storage we have hard disk or we have SSDs, and the capacity of hard disk in GBs or TBs. Okay. So that large amount of information computer can store in this secondary storage, and whenever we require any data it can be retrieved with ease. Okay. If we give the instructions to delete the data, only then the computer will delete the data from the secondary storage. Otherwise, it will not delete any data until we ask it to do for it. Then, no IQ. Computer does not have its own brain. We have to program the computer to make it work. Okay. It does only what it is programmed to do. Whatever instructions we have given to the computer, computer can perform only those tasks. It cannot think further or beyond those instructions. It cannot take its own decisions in regard of the instructions we provided. Okay. Then last one is no feelings. Computer do not have any kind of emotions. Okay. Their judgment is based on the instructions given to them in the form of programs that are written by us, means by humans. So computer do not have any kind of emotions. What they can do or what they can perform is based on the instructions which we have given them in the form of programs written by us. Okay, now we will be talking about stored program, yani means von Neumann architecture of the computer. Okay, so what is computer architecture? So computer architecture refers to the internal design of a computer with its CPU. Okay, how the computer is designed internally, and in this we generally talk about the CPU and how it interact with input and output devices. So it includes arithmetic logic unit, control unit, CPU registers, memory, input output interface, and external storage functions. Okay, so von Neumann architecture was designed by the renowned mathematician John von Neumann in year 1945. Okay, so the stored program architecture is also known as von Neumann architecture, and this is very widely used architecture in modern computer. Almost all modern computers are based on this von Neumann architecture. Okay, so what is the von Neumann architecture? Okay, so in this architecture, both data and instructions are stored in the same memory, and they are accessed using the same bus. Okay, using the same bus they are accessed. Okay, so here is the diagram of the von Neumann architecture. Okay, so two diagrams are there. First one is only the abstract diagram, because here we are showing only the memory and the CPU. Okay, we are not shown the input output system. Okay, and the second one is the complete architecture, or is the complete diagram of the von Neumann architecture. Okay, so this is the memory. Memory means what? RAM. So instruction and data both are placed in this single memory. Okay, there is no separation. Okay, and data and instruction both are accessed using the data bus. Okay, both are using this common bus. So CPU gets the instruction and data using the data bus, and again send them in the RAM using the same data bus. Okay, and what is the purpose of address bus? Address bus is used to provide the address of the memory location from where the CPU has to access the data or instruction. Okay, and this is the complete diagram of the von Neumann architecture. So here we have the main memory system in which both data and instruction resides. This is the entire central processing unit. So the components of CPU are displayed here, and here we have the input output subsystem. Okay, so there is a drawback of the von Neumann architecture. What is the drawback? That we cannot access instruction and data simultaneously. Okay, in this architecture we cannot access the data and instruction that will operate on that data at the same time, because single bus is used to access the data and instruction. Okay, and this is known as the von Neumann bottleneck, and it affects the system performance. So the system performance in von Neumann architecture is low. Okay, so I give you an example. Let's say CPU has an instruction. Okay, CPU already has an instruction, and now it will assess the memory to get the data. Okay, and now it performs the operation on this data. Okay, and now it has to send this data as the output. Okay, but now the data bus is communicating with the memory to get the next instruction. Okay, data bus is communicating with the memory to get the next instruction. Okay, so it is fetching the next instruction from the memory. So what will happen? Till then the CPU has to wait to get data bus to be free, then only it can send this data for the output. Okay, so in this case we are having some performance degradation. Okay, now we will be talking about the hardware architecture. Okay, so in hardware architecture, instructions and data are stored in separate memory units and are assessed using different buses. Okay, so here we can see we have two memory, one for instruction and one for data. Okay, and we have instruction bus to get the instructions from the instruction memory, and we have the data bus to fetch the data from the data memory. Okay, so but it generally does not happen that in reality we have two separate memories in the computer. Okay, so what actually happens that the main memory of computer is divided into two segments. Okay, do part isko divide kar diya jata hai. One part stores instructions and another part stores data. Okay, and then using the instruction bus we fetch the instructions, and using the data bus we fetch the data. Okay, so this is the hardware architecture. So what is the advantage? That instruction and data can be accessed from the memory simultaneously, so it overcomes the bottleneck of von Neumann architecture. Okay, but it is very expensive. The hardware architecture is very expensive. Okay, so many microcontroller architectures, like one which is used in the toaster, are hardware architectures. Okay, now we will be talking about difference between von Neumann and hardware architecture. Okay, so in von Neumann architecture, same physical memory is used for storing instructions and data, but in case of hardware architecture, separate physical memory is provided to store instructions and data. Okay, it is based on the stored program concept, and hardware architecture is based on the relay based computer models. Okay, in von Neumann architecture, common bus is used for transferring instructions and data. Single bus is there, both instruction and data are transferred using that single bus. Okay, and in hardware architecture, separate buses are used for transferring instructions and data. Instruction bus is used to access the instruction, and data bus is used to access the data. Okay, so two clock cycles are used to execute a single instruction in case of von Neumann architecture, because the first clock will be used to access the instruction, and the second clock will be used to get the data. Okay, and in case of hardware architecture, single clock cycle is used to execute a single instruction, because in the same cycle both data and instructions can be fetched from the memory. Okay. Harvard architecture is more expensive than von Neumann architecture. Okay, because it has two separate buses. Okay, and it divides the memory. So there should be some logic to find out that what area of memory occupies instructions and what area of memory occupies the data. Okay. Von Neumann architecture is cheaper in compared to the Harvard architecture. Okay. So all personal computers are based on the von Neumann architecture, and Harvard architecture is mainly used in microcontrollers and signal processing. Okay. So this is all for this lecture. If you have any doubt or any queries regarding to any topic in this video, then do not hesitate to mention those in comments. I assure you that I will give the answer and clarification of every question and doubt you have. Okay. So now we are at an additional topic, which is digital and analog computer. Okay. So what is a digital computer? Okay. So when we generally talk about computer, then we are talking about the digital computer. Okay. We do not talk about analog computers in general case. Okay. So digital computer uses distinct values to represent the data in the computer. Okay. So all the information, all the data is represented using two digits, zeros and ones. Okay. So digital computer works on the concept of zeros and ones. Okay. So all the computers which we see at our homes or offices or at other places, they all are digital computers. Okay. Now, what is an analog computer? So, analog computer represent data as variable across a continuous range of values. Okay. So, the earliest computers were analog computers. These computers are used for measuring parameters that changes or that vary continuously in real time, like temperature, pressure, voltage. To measure these parameters, analog computers are used. Okay. For example, slide rule, it is an earlier computer, is an example of analog computer. Thanks for watching. If you have any doubt or query, then kindly mention them in the comment. I will definitely provide the answers or clarification of the doubts. And till then, bye bye. See you in the next video.